So what GPU should you pick if you are a content creator? Should you go with AMD Radeon 7900 XTX or the Nvidia RTX 4090? In this video, we will analyze the latest PugetBench benchmark results to determine which of these GPUs is the better option for content creation. In the past, Nvidia GPUs have generally performed better than AMD GPUs in tasks such as video editing and other content creation workloads. So will the new AMD Radeon 7900 XTX surpass Nvidia's RTX 4090 and claim the top spot? Let's find out. Okay, let's start with the GPU effects benchmark. So this measures the performance of a GPU in OpenFX. So OpenFX includes stuff like warping, transformation, texturing, temporal effects, as well as a variety of other effects that are offered by DaVinci Resolve Studio Edition. This benchmark is particularly intensive in terms of GPU usage, as it also measures the GPU's performance in noise reduction, which is typically a very demanding task. So Radeon 7900 XTX comes very close to RTX 4080. It scores 173 points, which is just shy of 2 points. But the top dog is still Nvidia's RTX 4090 that scores 235 points, and it maintains a solid 35% performance lead over Radeon 7900 XTX. Next, let's take a look at the hardware decoding benchmark. This test measures a GPU's ability to efficiently handle the hardware decoding of H.264 and HEVC codecs. These codecs are among the most commonly used in consumer cameras, and as such, they are likely to be encountered frequently by video editors in their workflow. So a high score in this test will indicate that the GPU is capable of smooth video playback and smooth timeline scrubbing when you are doing video editing. Now, this is important for content creators who rely on smooth and seamless video editing, as a GPU that struggles with decoding certain codecs can lead to frustrating performance issues and also delays. So in the hardware decoding benchmark, AMD Radeon 7900 XTX scored 124.4 points, which is higher than 123.9 points scored by Nvidia's RTX 4090. So this is a significant win for the AMD Radeon 7900 XTX, as Nvidia GPUs have traditionally had better media decoders, and they have been the preferred choice for video editing. So that means Radeon 7900 XTX is looking like a strong contender for use in content creation workflows, especially video editing. Next, we are going to take a look at raw debayering test that measures the performance of a GPU in handling the debayering of raw footage from RED and from BRAW cameras. So in this test, the AMD Radeon 7900 XTX scored 92.9 points, outperforming Nvidia RTX 4090 by over 12%. I think this is particularly impressive result for the Radeon 7900 XTX, as it represents a massive 62% increase in performance compared to the previous generation Radeon 6900 XTX card. However, it is worth noting that the Nvidia RTX 4090 has been experiencing some driver optimization issues, and these issues have caused it to underperform in this particular test. In fact, the Nvidia's RTX 30 series cards have been outperforming RTX 4090, which is really crazy because this card is so expensive. So hopefully Nvidia will release updates to fix these issues and improve the performance of the RTX 40 series cards in the ray debayering test. And finally, let's take a look at the extended overall benchmark score that measures the overall performance of a GPU in a variety of tasks that are commonly used in DaVinci Resolve. So this benchmark is going to be a very good indicator of the performance that a typical DaVinci Resolve user can expect when running on their PC. In this case, the AMD Radeon 7900 XTX performs exceptionally well, achieving a 30% performance boost compared to the previous generation Radeon 6900 XT card. And this puts it at the top of the chart, beating Nvidia RTX 4090 by a narrow margin. However, it is worth noting that the performance of both RTX 4090 and the Radeon 7900 XTX, it's within the margin of error. And so that means their performance is likely going to be comparable, and in real life, you won't be able to tell the difference. Despite this, the AMD Radeon 7900 XTX still comes out ahead due to its lower retail price. Remember, this card sells for under $1,000, which is $600 cheaper than the retail price of Nvidia 4090. So here's the $1 million question. How on earth is AMD Radeon 7900 XTX performing so well in the PugetBench test for DaVinci Resolve? It's largely due to several architectural changes that AMD has implemented in their current generation of CPUs. One of these changes is doubling the total number of media encoders and decoders. This allows Radeon 7900 XTX to process and encode media files faster and more efficiently, and this leads to improved performance in tasks such as video editing and rendering. Secondly, AMD has introduced something called Smart Access Video Technology, and this is a significant innovation that has the potential to greatly improve performance in media processing tasks. Now, this technology allows the media encoders that are present in 7900 XTX GPU to be combined with the media encoders that are present in AMD Ryzen 7000 series CPUs, and this creates a more powerful and efficient system for encoding and decoding media files. To accomplish this, AMD has developed a new unified API and accompanying software stack that allows supported video editing softwares to take full advantage of all media encoders. This API and software stack allows for the distribution of encode and decode workloads across all media encoders found in Ryzen 7000 series CPUs and Radeon RX 7900 XTX GPUs. So this means that when you are rendering a high resolution video, the media encoders in the Radeon RX 7900 XTX GPU, they work in conjunction with those present in the Ryzen 7000 series CPU. The end result is that you are utilizing all available media encoders, and this allows for faster and more efficient processing of media files. Also, the Smart Access Video technology allows for more efficient use of system resources. This is because your task can be distributed across the GPU and the CPU, and so overall you are getting much more efficient workflow. So I think the introduction of this technology has greatly enhanced the capability of 7900 XTX, and it has made this GPU a potential top choice for professionals in media industry. Previously, many streamers and content creators relied on Nvidia's GPU due to their superior performance in video editing tasks. And this was largely due to Nvidia's strong track record in creating high quality video drivers and hardware media encoders and decoders. However, the success of Radeon RX 7900 XTX, as evident by these benchmarks, it shows that AMD is capable of delivering excellent performance in these areas as well. I think this will prompt Nvidia to respond by lowering their prices in order to remain competitive, or at least that's what I'm hoping. So here's the bottom line. I think that the increased competition in the video editing and content creation space, it's a positive development for us consumers. I think this will lead to more affordable and high performing GPU options for content creators and media professionals. Now, right now, both Nvidia RTX 4090 and the AMD Radeon RX 7900 XTX, they are both sold out at all the retailers here in US. This has led to a situation where both of these GPUs are being sold for significantly higher prices on websites like eBay. It is unclear when this high demand and resulting price inflation will end, but I hope that the prices will eventually return to more reasonable levels as supply catches up with demand and all these scalpers, you know, basically they lose money, they stop profiting from this situation. I don't know when this will happen. So here is what I will say. If you are planning to build a PC that will be able to accommodate large GPUs such as the Nvidia RTX 4090 or the AMD Radeon RX 7900 XTX, it is important to choose a case that will have enough space to hold these GPUs. So watch this video over here where I list the best cases that you can buy right now that will easily fit all these monster GPUs. By selecting a case that is suitable for your large GPU, you can ensure that your PC will run smoothly and efficiently. So go ahead and watch that video, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye!